all think our kids are great, but wouldn't it be nice to have quantitative evidence, a measurement tool? You will learn how my daughter truly is 4 times better than I am, and how she shaped me into the teacher I am today. Just before COVID isolation, my boss deputized me to give a speech about our after-school program. Because of all of my training through Toastmasters, I gave a fine half-hour speech, if I do say so myself, complete with visuals. After my talk, I deftly fielded an additional half hour of questions. The 20 or so people in the audience seemed genuinely interested and engaged. I thought I did such a good job. I was a little upset that my boss was not lavishing me with praise. That is, until one of the attendees donated $25,000 to our organization. Now my boss thinks I'm pretty great. Wow. If only I can make $25,000 for every hour I spoke. How does this relate to my daughter shaping me into the teacher I am today? I teach other people's children now because of what I learned while homeschooling my daughter. Her elder brother was easy to homeschool because he was a logical, sequential learner. She, on the other hand, was an intuitive, global learner. According to the University of Waterloo Center for Teaching Excellence, intuitive learners like discovering possibilities and relationships and working with ideas, and global learners prefer to organize information more holistically and in a seemingly random manner without seeing connections. They often appear scattered and disorganized in their thinking, yet often arrive at a creative or correct end product. There was only one problem. Not only am I a sequential logical thinker, but it is really hard to teach in anything but a sequential, logical manner. Teaching intuitively or globally is difficult because those thinkers are unique in their intuition. All of the methods I now use to teach a variety of thinking types, I learned from struggling to teach my daughter. Here is an example. One of the signs for being ready to start school is a one-to-one correspondence of numbers to objects. That is, if I give you 10 objects, you can reliably count those objects and come up with a total of 10, no matter how I organize the objects. My daughter lacked this essential skill when she was 6 years old, despite the fact that I had been actively teaching her using candy as counters as well as incentives. I was worried until the very next day she had one-to-one correspondence up to 100. How is this possible, you wonder? I too was curious, so I asked her. All those card games you played with my older brother while I was sitting in your lap finally sunk in, she said. Huh. Bolstered by the success of games, I implemented more and more games into all subjects of her curricula, and they seemed to not only help her learn, but to maintain her self-esteem, as she didn't learn as readily as her older brother. This led me to develop a K-12 math games curriculum, which I have used since with great success for all ages. I also used games and hands-on activities whenever I could to deepen her learning and eventually the learning of her younger brother, who is on the autistic spectrum. She opened my eyes to the fact that not everyone learns the same way, and I need to present information in a variety of venues to enhance retention. What does this have to do with my daughters being a 4 times better than I am? When my daughter was applying to colleges, she had an hour-long scholarship interview with an alumni. From that 1 hour chat, she was awarded a $25,000 scholarship. Needless to say, she went to that school. But I thought you said your daughter was 4 times better than you. She is. While I only got paid $25,000 for my hour-long speech, her $25,000 scholarship was repeated for each of her 4 years in undergraduate school. Not only is she 4 times better than I am, but she taught me how to teach. Thank you.